You are hunting on a billion-dollar company. You are poking around, testing the edges, and suddenly, one small endpoint shows you everything. All the customer's data sitting behind the wall. That's the power of IDOR. That's why IDORs are the single most dangerous bug class in modern web apps. And in this video, I'm not going to waste your time with definitions or theory. I'm not here to tell you what IDOR stands for. I'm here to show you how to actually find them with the techniques that work in real targets. So this is AmrSec, go get your cafe ready and let's dive in.
Channel has enough content.
As this is
before we jump in, let me share something real quick. I've been running on Yes We Hack lately, and honestly, it's been impressive. I'm talking about sending a report and getting a reply same day, even seeing some company's badge within hours. That's rare, that's different. I'm just saying this as a hunter, because speed matters. When your work gets triaged fast and fixed fast, you stay motivated. That's why I keep mentioning Yes We Hack, because for me, the experience speaks for itself. Alright, here is the reality. IDORs and broken access controls are everywhere. CRMs, e-commerce sites, fintech dashboards, healthcare portals, you name it. Every system built around users' data and permissions is sitting on IDOR landmines. The trick is not asking if an app has IDORs, the trick is asking where. And before you even think about flipping IDs, you need to understand that. Because blind guessing gets you nowhere, but targeting the right spots, that's how you land real bugs. Most beginners think IDOR hunting means changing the ID 10 to 9. That's not wrong, but it's incomplete. The mindset shift is this. Do not ask, can I change this number? And ask, what is the logic behind this endpoint? What assumptions is the app making? Because the developers are not thinking like you. They are thinking, show user details, show project details, return orders. They are not thinking, what if a hunter changes this ID and breaks my entire system? Your job is to see the blind spots. Your job is to step into assumptions and push until they break. So before we dive into the techniques, I want to tell you something. You have to understand what you are searching for and where. So we are working or searching for IDORs. Before, what I was doing is just doing some really good traffic, do my tests on the app. After this, get back to the HTTP history and start seeing the IDs and try to flip them. And most of the times it was 403, or maybe all the time, it was always 403. And I cannot just get any IDORs. And this because what I was thinking about is how I can find an ID and flip it. And I didn't think about bypassing this 403. That mindset shift made me able to land a large number of IDORs. And also you have to understand what you are targeting. If you are working on an e-commerce store, the products are public, the reviews are public, and your user profile most of the times will be slash my account, and it will return just an HTML rendered, so you will not be able to do things. So you have to understand where to search. For example, in e-commerce sites, try to search for the orders, order state, and so on. And for let's say CRM, try to search for the user management, and so on. It's just that simple. Alright, so let's ground this with an example. Imagine we are in an app and our user ID is 10. That's very first request we see looks like slash API slash version 5 slash users slash 10. Great, that's our own profile. Now what's happening if we flip it to 9? If the system is solid, we get 403 or 404. That's what we should get. But here is where the hunt starts. Because from this point forward, we are going to walk through real techniques, not theory, not slides, but actual tricks you can use to break these assumptions and turn a locked endpoint into a wide open door. And trust me, even if it looks basic, the right twist can turn it into something massive. That's the hunt, okay? So right here, I'm not going to create for you a fancy demo or something. I will just show you right here on my visual so you could. So as I said, our profile is basically this API endpoint, which given us 200 okay because it is our own profile. And if we did the same but this time we have the ID, which is 9. We will get something like basically 403, or we will get 404, okay? Because some apps just give you back 404 when you don't have permission to access this user. So that's the very basic thing. So the first technique we have is basically trailing slash or path normalization. So try the simple path variations first. Sometimes auth hooks miss weird slashes. So as I said, our ABI endpoint is /ABI/version5/users/10, which given us 200 okay. But when we try something like /9, it just given us 403. So the thing right here is just doing the same, but instead of just adding another user ID, just add a slash after it. If you think that this is weird and doesn't make any sense, it is, but I still get a bunch of IDORs with the same technique. So for this technique, that's pretty much it. Okay, the next technique we have is the double slashes or the obfuscated path. So the double slashes or dot tricks can slip through routes. So we here have the same thing. We have the same ID, which is giving us 200 okay. 9 giving us 403. But right here, we can try something like one slash. And if it didn't work, we can just add two or double slashes. If it also didn't work, we can just try to do the same for other things. Let's say slash users, double slashes, and after then the ID of the other users. And actually, this also work really well. All right, that's pretty much it. The next thing we have is the version downgrading. So right here, we have our ABI endpoints. Let's say these ABIs, this is our profile. So right now, when we try to get access to the user ID 9, it's given us 403. So what we can do right here is we can basically try to downgrade the ABI version, because legacy ABI versions sometimes skip modern auth checks. So try older versions. Right here, you can try something like basically version 4, version 3, version 2, version 1, all the way until you reach what you want. Okay, and also make sure that you do not just try one technique, try combining them. Okay, so that's also pretty much it. Also, there is another technique, the subpath or endpoint variant. So we also have the same endpoints, but right here, the only difference that we have other endpoints. So let's say that /ABI/version5/users/10, which is our profile, giving us all the user data with the orders and everything. But there is other endpoints such as /users/10/details, for example, which is return only the personal details. Other endpoints such as /orders, which is only return the orders. So this is our trick right here when we try to do the same endpoint, but for the user 9 only, just giving us 403 or 404. So the thing is, we're going basically to do the same ABI endpoint, okay? But the only difference right here that we will try to use another endpoint variant, such as details, for example, okay, or something like orders or whatever, and this will give us 200 okay. So yep, that's pretty much it. So I know this technique looks pretty simple, but trust me, just doing the normal ID flipping was not giving me any finding, but using these techniques is what actually helped me to land real findings. Okay, so the next thing we can try also is the multi-ID or filter parameter abuse. So we still have the same endpoint, which is giving us 200 okay. Let me stop here for a minute. Choosing which technique you want to use is not actually, these actually are not techniques that you have to use to find IDOR. This is wrong, but they just worked with me multiple times. That's why I show them to you. But all the things that I'm telling you right now is just stands on what you see in the response. So let's say that I have added the user 9 and I got 403 or 404, and I've tried to add something like, for example, 9 and just single quote, and it's giving me server error, or maybe it's going to give me like invalid user ID. So this is a completely different response. So all of it is just based on the response and how you get it. Okay, so in this example, we can try something like basically using the same endpoint, but instead of just using the ID 9, we can try to do something like 9 and 8, for example. And sometimes this work, and most of the times will not, because we already don't have access to the user ID 9 or even 8, so we will not get anything. Maybe we can do something better. We can try to use the user ID 10, which is ours, and after this we can try to add something like 9. And maybe also this will not work, so we can try to change the comma to be dot and 9 and see what we will get. That's actually how it works. Maybe it's not like this completely, and it's just something like where ID equal 10, and from here we can make it 10 and 9. Okay, so just you have to understand what's happening. Maybe when you add something like this, you will get a response saying invalid user ID 10 and 9, and from here you will just move to another technique completely. So that's pretty much it. So the next technique we have is basically the type confusion, which is string versus integer. And sending a string instead of numbers can trigger different parsing paths. So right here we still have the same two endpoints. So right here, what if we try to change this 9 to be something like this? Okay, so the server waiting for an integer, because this is the user ID. What if you give it something like this? What's gonna happen? Or you may give it something like this, okay, and see what's gonna happen, because sometimes it will just remove these strings and take the integer, which will maybe bypass the protection or something like this. So this also a technique that works really well, which also give you 200. Okay, and also we can try something like deleting zeros, whether it's hex or alternate formats. So we have the same ABI endpoints we get 403 when we just access the normal ID. We can do something like this. We will just add a leading zero and see what's happening. Or we can do something like basically this, okay? And this also will give us 200, okay. That's pretty much it. From now, the techniques becomes more smart. Right here, we can try something like the null termination or Control-Char encoding. So still have the same endpoints, but we have a trick right here. We can basically add after the user ID 9, we can add something like a null byte, which is something like this. And that's basically it. Try to add it after the ID, before the ID, add it with ID and add a slash, add double slashes, you know, just do whatever you want. But the main goal right here, that just of leaving the ID will not give you the detail. So you have to try harder and make sure to try these things on really important endpoint. So when you get something, you will land real data. Okay, so this also will work. After this, we have something that's a little bit tricky. It's not working all the time, but it worked with me like 2 or 3 times. That's why I will share it right here, which is the header or proxy-based bypass, X original URL or X forwarded forest style. So have the same endpoints, but the only difference right here that we will use this endpoint with something. So we will use this endpoint, which is not our ID, but with it, we will use something like X original URL. And after this, we will add our main URL or accessible one. And sometimes this works. And we can also do the same, but the only difference right here that we will use X forwarded 4. So it is X forwarded 4. And also we will add our accessible endpoint right here. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this one. Now I want to tell you about the last technique we have. And this one that's gave me multiple real bugs, high and critical bugs. It is stupidly simple. Encoded space or subtle URL encodes that cause inconstant normalization between layers. I call this one the percentage 20 bypass. It's the one you should try if nothing else works. So here is how it works. So you already guessed it, because I have said that it is stupidly simple, but right here it's just, it is really simple. Like if I just come right here and just we have the user ID 10, which is my user ID, and 9 giving me 403. What I will do is just try again, but this time I will just add here percentage 20. So here, let me stop for a minute. This happens when I try to get the user's details for me, for my user ID on a real target. And when I added my ID, it just giving me the details. The first thing I've tried is adding comma, and after this adding another ID. And the thing is, it just showed me invalid user ID, and in just brackets showed me my ID and comma the other ID. So I thought like, okay, so if I added anything like not an integer, it will just say that it is invalid because it's not my ID, right? So I have tried to add like some encoding, but it is still can see that this is a thing that the server cannot just accept it. So I just tried to add a space and it worked. I just got a lot of users' details just by this. And it's really high in bug. Like the bug severity was like, I don't know, 7.7 or something like this, CVSS score. So yeah, that's pretty much it. And again, I will mention this one more time. If one trick fails, combine them. Downgrade plus encoding space plus trailing slash. What's gonna happen? Try multiple tricks. Try to understand how the server behaves and trick it. Because just throwing tricks or just throwing payloads will not help you find what you want. You have to understand what is the app waiting for. Is it waiting for integer? Is it waiting for a string? Is it just taking any input and start processing it so you can move to another direction from there? So you have just to understand how the app behave. By doing that, you will exactly find what you are looking for. So that's the checklist. Short tricks, constant testing, and the percentage 20 trick that kept giving me wins. So if you practice this in order, this will increase your chances of turning a 403 into a full exploited chain. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Okay, quick checklist to drill into your notes. First, APIs are your surface. Find the JSON endpoints, not the rendered HTML. Second, fast and cheap tricks, trailing slash, double slash, subpaths, query filters. Try version downgrades, older APIs often skip modern checks. Test type and encoding, strings, leading zeros, percentage 20, control charts, tiny changes but big difference. And combine tricks if one fail, downgrade plus encoding plus best tweaks, keep testing low noise, reduct sensitive output, log exact request plus status for the BOC. That's it. Practical, repeatable checks that turns a boring 403 into real finding if you know where to push. If you want more videos like this, short tactical breakdowns of the techniques I actually use, let me know in the comments and I will keep bringing them. So, if you found this video helpful, do not forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more cybersecurity content. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments below or you can reach me on Twitter. Until next time, stay curious and stay secure.